Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is model skin, and model skin to me is flawless. It's glowy, it's still natural looking, but you feel snatched. You feel like the best version of yourself. I say this in the video, but makeup is not about changing yourself. It is about feeling the best that you can feel. And we're gonna be going through a lot of my skin techniques, which has changed. They have changed so drastically over the years. That is what we're doing today. Subscribe down below and give this video a thumbs up. Let's get started. So one of the biggest things you want to think of when doing this model skin look is the skin prep. It's actually weird how hard it is to get the skin to look like you're not wearing that much makeup, but we're sculpting the face to give us that like flawless model skin vibe. But yeah, skin prep is like the most important thing, honestly. The less makeup you want to look like you're wearing, the harder it is to achieve, because you really have to focus on the skin prep, the techniques, how you're blending things in to achieve more of like that no makeup makeup look, versus if you're just putting on a full coverage foundation, which obviously looks amazing and there's a time and a place. But yeah, if you're going for this like model skin look, skin prep is number one. So I went in with a really nice moisturizer. This is Murad Intense Recovery Cream, and I have already done my like morning skincare toner, serum, moisturizer, and this is like the double layer of moisturizer because I really like this one underneath my makeup. It really like seeps into the skin to just give a really smooth, hydrated feel and look. And then while we do our brows, I'm gonna go in with a little eye mask, which has been legit. I don't know why recently, but I've been obsessed with eye masks. I feel like they just like wake me up. They help me get in the groove and just, I don't know, they're just my vibe, okay? So we're gonna pop that baby on. I love, 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 love doing this as part of my makeup routine. For some reason, it just makes me feel luxurious. Like I feel luxe right now. And the ones I use are Shiseido, the Benefiance Wrinkle Resist 24 Retinol Express Smoothing Eye Mask. So I'm just gonna leave that on while I go ahead and do my brows. And I'm using powder today because I want a little soft brow look. So this is the Dominique Cosmetics Transition Palette, and I'm using the shade Ash. Literally just took me 20 minutes to do my brows. So we're gonna move to primer. And I'm gonna do a little primer cocktail just because I like to blur out my pores and imperfections in the middle of my face where they really, you know, show through in the makeup. And then I like to hydrate the rest of the face. So I'm gonna use the Makeup Forever Hydra Booster Step 1 Primer. This stuff is amazing. It is super, super hydrating. Makes my makeup look amazing. It has this like peachy, slight peachy undertone, so it really brightens up my skin. And it feels just so good on the skin too. So I'm just gonna take that all over my forehead, all over my cheeks. We're gonna be hydrated. Then for the T-zone in the middle of the face, I'm taking the Shiseido Synchro Skin Soft Blurring Primer. And really just target the middle of the face with this. And really work it into the pores because that's how we're gonna get that super smooth effect. So we're not done with skin prep, I know, but this is legitimately the most important part of the whole thing, is how you take care of your skin, how your skin looks underneath the makeup. It's gonna make a huge, huge difference. So taking these extra steps is what is gonna allow us not to use as much actual makeup products. So I'm gonna go in with the Glow Recipe Watermelon Glow Niacinamide Dewdrops. Love, 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 love these. And I take this over the same areas, kind of like on the outside portion of the face, especially where the light is gonna hit. Oh, they smell so good. Oh my God. It's crazy how good they smell. And this is one of my like top, not even secrets because I've talked about it before, but like top tips for that really luminous skin vibe. So this is Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter. It looks like a foundation. It's not a foundation. It goes underneath your foundation, or you can wear it on its own if you really want like a light skin day. But what it does is it has very light, very minimal coverage to it. But once you work it into the skin, it like brings your skin to life and kind of blurs over the skin to create an even base while adding a lot of radiance, a lot of glow, an even tone. Do you see the difference? Like, it's almost like if somebody were to take a flash photo, like a photo with flash of you and your skin, you know when your flash just like kind of like blurs out your skin and makes it look bomb? That's what this gives me, like a flash effect. Like, so yeah, on days when like I don't really want to put on my full foundation routine, but I just want my skin to look a little more alive, have a little color to it, this is the product that I've been reaching for. It's so, so good. All right, I'm gonna go in with this little color corrector from Bobbi Brown. This is the shade Peach Bisque. And I'm gonna take this under the eyes. And remember, we're not really gonna be using that much concealer. So it's really important to get your skin ready. So I'm also gonna take this corrector on top of any redness, any blemishes. I feel like it does a pretty good job of canceling that out as well and blending into my skin. Then I'm actually gonna take a little bit of this. This is from RCMA Makeup Foundation / Concealer Palette in VK number 10. And I take a mix of these two shades down here at the bottom. And I start to build up my contour even before we have foundation because, you know, my face is a little round. I don't have that like snatch that typically you think of when you think of models. But then at the same time, like in my head, I'm like, models come in all shapes and sizes, obviously. And I'm really trying to like learn to love my round face. So instead of thinking like, you know, I don't have this snatch, I'm like, you know what? I have a beautiful face and I'm gonna enhance it with a little contour, but my face on its own is amazing. Like I literally had a miniature meltdown this morning before I was gonna film this video because I felt so self-conscious and so like, well, I don't look like a model. I don't have the bone structure of a model. So like, why am I gonna do this makeup look? I'm super lucky to have Joe. I actually called him and I was like, what should I do with my hair? Like, I don't feel like my hair looks good with my face shape. He really talked some sense into me, honestly, and I feel extremely lucky to have, like, talked to him about it this morning because I snapped out of it. And I'm only saying this because it's a reminder that we all go through things like this and you're not alone if you're feeling like that and you're beautiful the way you are. And we're just using makeup to enhance, not change ourselves. You know what I mean? I do love me a good contour, you know? So I'm putting this all over the outer sections of the face. I wanna feel confident. I wanna feel like the best version of myself. And that a lot of times is what makeup brings me. Then we're gonna go in with foundation. And I'm using the Shiseido Sinker Skin Radiant Lifting Foundation. I'm gonna take one pump. And I typically, when I'm doing this skin technique, don't even use the full pump. Which is so crazy because you guys know back in the day, I just pound on the foundation. It's gonna look great. It did look good at the time, but now my skin technique has evolved a lot where like I want it to look so much more natural and I want, you know, my freckles to show through and little imperfections are okay and all those things. So I'm just taking slight, like bit by bit, putting this on my foundation brush to create a nice even base. And when I get to my contour, I do kind of lift up just because we already have that down. And I'm just gonna buff that in. And this is a really, really light layer that I'm creating, as you can see. It's all about the layering. It's all about the fresh, dewy skin look. And you can see I still have a pretty good bit left. So I'll just kind of pat that into any areas that I feel need a little bit more coverage. So once I'm done with that, I'm gonna go in with my concealer. And the concealer that I'm gonna use, you really wanna look for something that has like that pink undertone because again, it's just gonna cancel out those under eyes and really create that like flawless looking skin. So I'm gonna use Makeup Forever Ultra HD Concealer in the shades 32.5 and 34, and you can see this one is just slightly lighter, slightly more pink. So I take these, the little mixture on the back of my hand. This Smashbox concealer, buildable concealer brush. I use that to blend the two shades together first and foremost. Then I really take a small amount. Like, I can't stress that enough, which is so weird. You would think that it's the opposite, that you need a lot of concealer. But what we're really using this concealer for is actually just to highlight. You want to create the shape of those, like, very, you know, feminine model eyes. You know what I'm talking about. That very, like, kind of vibe. So I'm just taking the smallest amount, patting it right at the inner corner, and then bringing it out towards the end of the eyes. A little bit on the chin, and I do this like lifting area right near the mouth because I get shadows right here. We're just gonna blend that in. And you can see it's not like the shade that I created with those two shades is not that different from my foundation color, which is what you want for this, again, very natural, glowy, skin-like look, because once you go really light, that's when it starts to get a bit more unnatural looking, just because it's gonna look like you're wearing brighter makeup under the eyes. And the concealer placement under the eyes, it brings a lot more light and lift to the area, which I always feel looks very model-like. And I just go in with a little bit more contour just to touch it up. And if you don't have a concealer palette like this, you can totally use any concealer that you have at home. I would just say probably like something that's 2 to 3 shades darker than your foundation shade. Then we're gonna take a little bit of Giorgio Armani Fluid Sheer. This is a liquid blush, and it's like the perfect shade for this natural Libra that we're going for. This is the shade 11, and it's like a really neutral, slightly peachy pink with some gold shimmer running through it. But you don't really see the gold shimmer unless you're in light. Like, it doesn't look glittery by any means. It's a very, very pretty natural blush shade. Oh, I feel like I've come back to life. Okay, so I am gonna go in with my bottle. So this is a technique that I showed in one of my recent videos on how to cover dark circles. So I'm just gonna take a little teeny bit of this Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin powder in the shade R230 and press that under the eyes to create a nice smooth base. It's the best powder for this step too, because it makes your skin look like velvet. So, so good. But see how it still looks natural? Even though we're set and ready to go, it still has like very natural look when you apply with a beauty blender. And I'm just continuously pressing that into the skin. I've moved to my brush now. But this is not the same exact technique under the eyes, because the one that I did in that video was a lot more full coverage. This one I kind of want the divots to show a little, because I want to be like a natch snatch kind of vibe. So that's why it may look a little different. So after this, we're gonna add on some bronze. And this is one of my personal favorite parts because I feel like it gives you that very natural sun-kissed look. So we're doing Laura Mercier today. This is bronze number 4 of their Matte Radiant Bronzing Powder. I'm just really lightly gonna go around the sides of the face. And this also helps to set this area. Then for blush, I'm gonna do MAC Melba, which for some reason this always reminds me of like model skin, because it has that very, again, neutral peachy undertone. And I'm gonna keep this kind of higher up than I normally would, because I'm trying to lift my face. When you start to add it here, which I actually do a lot, like that's a big vibe of mine, it gives more of like a rounded baby doll kind of look, which is so beautiful as well. But when you're wanting to lift a bit more, I would recommend going up on the sides. All right, and of course we have to do some highlights. So I'm using my fave palette, Dior. This is their copper gold highlighting palette, and I typically take this top shade. It has such a beautiful reflect to it. I'm actually gonna wet my skin first with MAC Fix Plus. Then I'm gonna wet my brush as well. Dip into that top left shade, and just right before, I'm gonna wait a second, because right before your face dries, that's when you wanna apply your highlight, okay? But we gotta wait a little bit, because if you do it too early, it's gonna take off like the foundation and the hard work we've put in already. Oh. see how that just gives you dimension, but it doesn't look glittery, and doing that little spray of Fix Plus really helps to just seamlessly blend out the highlight and make it really pop. And I'm gonna go back into the Transitions palette from Dominique Cosmetics and contour the nose a little bit. All right, and just taking a little bit of brown eyeshadow right on the outer corner of the eyes. I'm really not doing a ton of eyeshadow, but I want that like lifted look on the outer corners. I'm just gonna smudge it out with my finger to make it nice and natural looking. Genuinely my favorite eyeshadow technique right now is just smudging it out, because there's no mistakes that can be made. It's literally the easiest thing ever. And we're just gonna curl the lashes and add on some mascara after this. And I really, really focus the mascara on the outer corner of my eyes, because again, I want to achieve that like cat eye shape. And obviously this tutorial was a bit more about the skin, but just a simple eye look will do for the eyes. Like, I'm not gonna put mascara on the bottom lashes. I'm just gonna really focus it on this outer corner. And I kind of take like the tip of the wand, just the tip, kind of just like glide it along the edges to build up this outer corner. And this is NARS Climax Extreme. And I'm just gonna add on a little bit of lip pencil. I kind of want it to look like softer around the edges, not too defined. So I'm using Morphe Sweet Tea. This is my version of not too defined. I love the like 90s model nude where it's a bit more rosy, kind of like a taupey shade. So I'm going in with MAC Cosmetics Taupe around the edges. This is legit like the perfect 90s model shade. And then I'm gonna take 1995 from Pat McGrath and put that right in the middle. This is like my vibe though. Honestly, this is me in a makeup look these days. Like natural, radiant, glowy, but not too glam. I'm not a big glam girl right now, which is so crazy because I used to be all about it, but I'm really loving the natural makeup looks and then mixing together these kind of like taupey mocha tones. That's just been my vibe lately. So anyways, I hope you guys like it. Let me know if you do. Subscribe down below, give this video a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video.
Bye guys.